Hello everybody, I am here today with a video I have not done in a long time, but it is a video that you guys used to love, and it is...
Comics I Hate.
So, because I haven't done this in a long time, I have a bag full. So, just a disclaimer, like in all of my other videos, some of these products are stinker products of awesome brands. Not every brand makes every product that they make amazing. So there's nothing against the brands. These are brands that I use normally, but it's just a product in that brand or in that line that I just don't like for whatever reason. And it might just be because it's not right for me. So let's start. So the first product is this Prevana Color Protect. This is a shampoo. Yes, it's empty. I did use all of it because we're in quarantine right now and times are tough. This shampoo just isn't my favorite. I generally use Paul Mitchell Olive Pooey Wild Ginger, and it's a really good color safe shampoo that actually lathers. This shampoo lathered, but I just felt like it didn't get my hair clean, and I only wash my hair every like second, third, fourth day, so when I have a lot of oil in my hair, I need a shampoo that's color safe that's gonna really cut through that oil. And I felt like when I was in the shower, I would have to shampoo my hair like 4 times, not even kidding, to get it clean, and then when I got out of the shower, I still felt like there was oil in my scalp. So this would probably be a better product for fine hair, not so much for my thick hair. Next product is another product that is not a bad product, but not the right product for me. And this is Kiehl's. This is the Calendula Deep Cleansing Foaming Face Wash. Face wash. Again, probably an amazing product for somebody that has oily skin. In general, you don't want a gel cleanser if you have dry skin. Obviously, this says normal to oily skin, so I started using it before I looked to see what skin type it was for, and I have dry combination skin. So this was not for me. This was very drying. So if you do have crazy oily skin or you wear a ton of makeup, this might be right for you, but if you have dry skin, I would say no way. So this next product is Pixi On The Glow. It is a multi-use moisture stick. Again, Pixi is a brand I love and I use a lot. This particular thing, it's basically like, it looks like a deodorant stick, and it's just meant to be like a moisturizer on the go for your face or your hands or your body or whatever. Maybe good for like feet or calloused bits of your body, but it is so greasy. I would not use this on your face. I even have dry skin and it was too greasy for me. So, not my favorite. This next product is by Dr. Brandt. It is Extend Your Youth. It is essentially a lip plumper. It's called a lip filler and volumizer. I really just feel like it didn't do anything. It was kind of watery. It didn't have good thick texture, so I didn't really feel like it stayed on my lips very well. Smell is
gross.
Smells kind of medicinal. Just not my favorite. I think there's better lip plumpers and lip products out there to extend your youth, your lip youth of your lips. This next one is another hair product, and this is by Hair La Vie. It is a conditioner. It is a detangle, hydrate, and restore conditioner. Basically, it just sucked. I have really, really dry hair, so I need a conditioner that's gonna really get in there. If I'm in the shower and I'm putting the conditioner in my hair, and it's not immediately allowing me to run my fingers through my tangly, wet hair, it is not the conditioner for me. So this, again, may be better for fine hair or hair that's not so dry, but my is too dry, and it is color safe. It's all the good stuff. It just wasn't thick enough for my hair or strong enough for my hair. So this next thing is Derma-E Purifying Daily Detox Scrub. I don't want no scrubs. With activated charcoal. I actually got this at Whole Foods when I was on the road because I ran out of face wash and I was like, oh, ethical beauty. Yeah, let's do this. First of all, a face scrub especially should get the stuff off your face. This wouldn't even get BB cream off my face. I could still see streaks of BB cream on my face after I use this. The other thing that I hate about this stuff, disclaimer, I am a whiskey drinker and I like the smell of whiskey, but this smells like whiskey. Like it smells like maybe like Jack Daniels. I don't like American whiskey, but I don't want that smell on my face. So this is just kind of an all over fail. So again, in that vein is the Centella Sensitive Facial Cleanser. This is by Kiehl's. This is another one that it was just not strong enough. I don't have sensitive skin and I do wear makeup. So a cleanser like this, I feel like is better for somebody that doesn't wear makeup and has sensitive skin that's really just using their cleanser to get like natural oils and stuff off of their face. But this for me did nothing. This might also be good in a double cleanse, like maybe if you're using like an oil first and then a cleanser like this, or if you have very, very, very dry skin and you need something really hydrating. But for me, this didn't really do the job. So I don't know. I'm double cleansing now, and I wasn't when I started using this, so maybe I'll give it another go. I do love Kiehl's. I hate putting Kiehl's in my products. I hate, but just wasn't for me. So this next one is another Pixi, and this is the Makeup Fixing Mist. I put these things in my little products I hate bag. I just want to show you guys it actually. Mm-hmm. My neighbors. That guy drives on our road every day in this red Mustang, and he drives way too fast, and it makes everybody mad. So that guy had the right yell. Anyways, my products I hate bag, as you can see, in case I confuse it with any other bag in my house. This is the most aggressive bag in my house. So anyways, I started putting products I hate in my products I hate bag, I don't even, like maybe a year ago. So I'm not 100% sure why I hated this or why I put it in there. My thinking is how it sprays. Usually that's how it is. So yep, that's exactly what it is. So if you can see, it like bonsais out of there. And when you go to put it on your face to fix your makeup, it just like sticks on just a couple parts of your face. The smell also reminds me of like my mom's face powder in the 80s. Oh no, I've sprayed it all over me. Not my favorite. So for this, it's a mix of the smell and the way it sprays. I'm sure the actual product is just fine. Most of the other mists that Pixi make are great. And last but not least is this Wrinkle Smoothing Cream by Dr. Brandt. It is called Wrinkles No More. Honestly, I put this in this bag before I went to esthetician school. I don't even know, the ingredients are not on here, so I don't really know what the ingredients are in here. The problem with this cream I found is that I need a really heavy cream at night. And this is meant to go just on the parts of your face that are wrinkly. So I found that it was really inconvenient to just smooth this on my wrinkles and then put the rest of my cream on the rest of my face, because this is really creamy and it doesn't absorb very well. So if you were to wait for the whole thing to absorb and then put cream over the top of your face, it would take forever. But if you put it on and then put cream on immediately after, you're just wiping it all off and kind of defeating the purpose. So it's not so much the product that's bad, it's just kind of the process of applying it that wasn't my favorite. So, that is it. Those are all the products I I do have to say, though, for all the stuff that I get for free to try from companies and all the stuff that I just try anyways because I'm curious, there's not a lot that I hate or I dislike. And most of the time I don't like it, it's just because it's not right for either my hair type, my skin type, it smells funny or whatever it is. Thankfully, this time there was nothing that smelled like vomit, so that's always a plus. But that's it. If you guys want to see more products I hate videos, please let me know. For products that I love, I'm always including the products that I love and use in my normal videos. So check out my skincare videos, check out my makeup videos, and anything that I'm using in those videos are the products I love. People ask me for products I love videos, but I feel like it's kind of redundant because I'm already using the stuff that I actually like. So that is it. I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy. And I will see you in the next one.